What's up, everyone, and welcome back to Movie Raise. If you thought The Kissing Booth is great, wait till you see Two Hearts. And just like The Kissing Booth, Two Hearts managed to sign Jacob Elordi as the lead in this movie. He's playing Chris, a college student who falls in love with Sam, played by Tierra Scoveby. And if you want to know the juicy little details about the story, as well as some spoilers, then keep on watching. In today's video, we will be looking at Two Hearts, everything you need to know. So, let's dive right into it. What is Two Hearts? Besides a movie, why is Two Hearts actually important? Well, for one, it's not your everyday love story. In this movie, we have the lives of two couples intertwined in ways that no one thought possible. What do we mean by this? Two men fall madly in love with the women of their dreams, but as luck would have it, one of them suffers from a rare disease. As for the other one, the younger one, Lady Luck just decided to play a cruel trick on the fate of his young soul. And it's precisely this mysterious love that made the movie go viral instantly.
That it was a good story to tell and give everybody hope that miracles do happen.
Does this mean the movie is out? No, not really. It's supposed to hit theaters on the 16th of October, 2020, which is only a month away. Assuming that this COVID-19 pandemic calms down by then, otherwise we're probably going to be looking at a postponed release date, which doesn't really tickle our fancy. And with such an interesting story and an amazing cast, we're thinking this movie is going to become an instant hit with fans all across the world. Okay, we know the movie is good, but when can we watch the trailer? You can do that right now. The trailer has been released 2 months ago, and there are numerous channels that uploaded it to their platform. The most viewed one is by Freestyle Releasing, and the trailer already has more than 28 million views in 2 freaking months. We told you it's going to be epic. But Movie Raise, having a lot of views doesn't mean anything. What about likes and dislikes? Where are the comments? Hold your horses, buckaroo. We're getting to those. But first, smash that like button if you haven't done it already. Anyway, as we were saying, the trailer already has 55,000 likes and less than, get this, 500 dislikes. That means more than 99% of people actually like what they saw in the trailer. And when it comes to comments, we'll admit there's only about 900 of them, almost all of which are positive and talking about how the trailer is so mysterious. They can't really understand the storyline of the movie. Plus a few comments from Jacob's fans talking about how good he is in the movie. Never hurt, do they? But we get it. We'll also admit that this movie trailer had us scratching our head the first time we watched it. So let us fill you in on the details and tell you what we found out about this movie. First things first.
Been married for 46 years now.
Given your history, we're not very optimistic.
Every morning I wake up and I turn over in my bed and I look and see that he is still there.
Is it based on a true story? In the trailer, we see this small snippet of text that says the movie is based on a true story. We wanted to know whether it's actually true or it's just a trick used by the producers to boost viewership. We did a little digging around and we found out that it's actually true. This movie is based on a true story. So, what's the whole story about? Well, seems like the actual people in which the story is based are actually pretty rich. And you could say famous. Why do we say this? Because the older man, Jorge Bacardi, played by Aidan Canto, was actually a descendant from the famous rum maker Bacardi. So, as we said, he's kind of famous. There's no way you haven't heard of Bacardi rum. And what's Jorge's story all about? Even though he was born in a wealthy family, this man was born with one of the rarest lung diseases. Doctors thought it would be a miracle if he lived to be 10 years old. He sure beat doctors' expectations and is now actually 76 years old. So, how did he manage to live for so long? First of all, the disease kept progressing, and it came to a point where it was extremely difficult for Bacardi to breathe. They were placed on a waiting list for a lung transplant while he and his wife lived in the Bahamas. And what happened in March of 2008? The man who donated the lungs.
Lucky to play Leslie. She's a really amazing woman in real life. It was one of the most sort of moving experiences in my acting career.
Chris Gregory, the man that saved 5 lives. Just starting college, Chris Gregory was 19 back in 2008. He was at a friend's house when all of a sudden he collapsed on the floor. They call 911 immediately. And this freshman was rushed to the Tulane University Medical Center. He was still alive, but they later found out that the reason for Gregory's collapse was a rupture brain aneurysm. He was breathing heavily, and his doctors, for the Gregory family, that his condition worsened. This was the very next day. And while the parents were trying to cope with the bad news, the doctor topped it all off with, "This is death." He was dead, just like that. Family members couldn't believe what had happened. His father said that he never saw it coming, and neither did we. In an instant, everything changed. But despite the sorrow, this dark cloud had a silver lining. Even though the family was left with the burden of their son's loss, Chris registered himself as an organ donor when he was 16 years old. And get this, a week before his death, he was telling his parents how he wanted to become an organ donor. His death was not in vain. His death managed to save 7 lives in the process, including the life of millionaire Jorge Bacardi. When news hit the family, they immediately flew to Jacksonville. The doctors immediately rushed him to the ER and performed a 7-hour-long double lung transplant surgery. To show everyone that he never gave up, Jorge was up and walking in the hospital halls just 24 hours after the surgery. This led some of the nurses to give him the nickname Superman.
I think the movie's wholesome. It's the kind of movie you can watch with your whole family.
The legacy that is Chris. So Jorge and Leslie wanted to play tribute to the man that saved 5 lives with his death. Jorge, who couldn't walk 10 feet without his oxygen tank and assistance, was now up and going. And to pay homage to the life of Chris, they wanted to share their story with the world, as well as tell it through a movie. Now, we don't know how big of a part of the original story they're going to keep in the movie, because we did see that Chris and Sam actually had a baby together. Furthermore, Jorge and Leslie were constantly on set, helping the actors and the writers to tell the story in detail. On top of all that, they did this movie in the hopes of promoting the act of organ donation, which could end up saving another person's life. And Jorge has been so dedicated to the cause that they actually donated a huge sum of money to support the regenerative medicine at the Mayo Clinic. And as if all of those things weren't enough, the Bacardis even built the Gabriel House of Care in honor of Chris Gregory. It's intended to house those who are unlucky to own a house in their own life. Leslie says that Chris's spirit helped bring the house together, and hopefully his legacy lives on.
A great life together. Rhoda Mitchell, who played my role, did a brilliant job.
Who's going to be starring in it? With such a moving story, it's no wonder so many people have watched the trailer. And the director responsible for this movie is none other than Lance Houle. He is a 72-year-old director that was an actor, writer, executive producer, chairman of a distribution company, and his most lucrative talent, director. The number of movies he's produced in his lifetime is 25, 2 of which were number 1 at the U.S. box office. One of them featured Chuck Norris, and it was titled Missing in Action. The movie came out in 1984 and managed to make $22.8 million at the box office. The other movie was titled Man of Fire, and it came out in 2004. If you're old enough to remember this classic, it featured Denzel Washington, Dakota Fanning, and Christopher Walken. This one made a whopping $130 million at the box office. So, to say that this guy knows what he's doing would be a gross understatement of his abilities. When talking about the actors, we already mentioned some of them, but here they all are in one place. Chris is going to be portrayed by Jacob Elordi. Sam will be played by Tierra Scobie. Aidan Canto had the role of Jorge, and his wife Leslie will be portrayed by Rhoda Mitchell. Some of the other actors from the movie include Katie Matchett, Tom O'Pinnicott, Steve Basic, and Malcolm Stewart. The only thing left for us to do now is pray the movie is going to be as good as the real story, or maybe even better. And judging from Houle's past movies, this one is going to be top-notch. And on that note, we end this video. But hey, did you add this new Elordi movie to your watch list already? You can tell us in the comment section below. If you'd like more videos like these, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon so you never miss any of them. And as always, thanks for watching, guys.